got a glass beer bottle bottom here that I'm working into a point. This one's pretty straight. It's a little bit curved, but they usually all have a little bit of curve, and point is to straighten them out. And this is probably the most easily accessible flint knapping material. Got a pretty good blank here going so far. I think I'll just start pressure flaking on it. Got the square edge going right here. See that? So let's get rid of that. Take a flake and then turn it over. Take a flake. Turn it over, take a flake. So with the curved bottom, my goal isn't to really press flakes into there. I want to raise this edge up. I'm going to work on the base too a little bit, but I want to raise this edge up and then start taking flakes into there to help kind of get rid of that curve. So I got the first set of flakes going on the surface. This bottom was kind of conveniently shaped, and usually you, if you want to get the bottom out, you gotta put a nail in there or find a way to break it off safely. I saw this one and it was already kind of in the triangular shape and the bottom wasn't curved too much. So if you find broken glass somewhere and you find the bottom and it's not too bad, you can recycle it just like this. Thank you. So when it comes to the curve, and it's not even that bad anymore, and I've been taking shorter flakes on the bottom to kind of build up the convexity in order to push flakes off that are, it'll give me the convexity to give it a good little platform that I can push flakes off, and it won't dive into there. So let's see if I can. It's not too bad. I kind of just play it by ear when I'm napping a piece and try and figure out how much I need to take off. Which is good practice. So if you get your hands on some bottle bottoms, you can work on your pressure flaking and building up rows of platforms. Especially if you're limited on rock. Probably stop it here and then do a part two.